Hey everyone, it is Wednesday, November 30th. The time is around 11:32 a.m. and the temperature right now is around 7 degrees Celsius. I'm here just in front of Sherbourne Station at the intersection of Sherbourne and Bloor Street East. And that is a look to the west. And for this one, I'm going to be making my way south, eventually ending up in front of the Eaton Centre. And as you can see, it is raining right now. I've been kind of hoping for more snow, but I'll have to take what I can get. This wind is proving to be quite strong. And this would be Howard Street coming up. There's a pretty good puddle to jump over. Sorry.
That's why I closed mine down. It makes no sense.
This is supposed to be windproof too. Wow. I have to get that sorted.
It's gonna damage it. It's too windy, man.
It's supposed to be windproof. We'll see.
Okay.
Have a good day. Now you can see the bike lane. It is becoming a mess of puddles. At least the wind has died down, but I had to hold on to this thing with a death grip. Yeah, this is a Rappel brand umbrella. They cost a little more than your standard umbrella like this. I found they actually tend to hold up quite well in wind. That was just an extremely powerful gust. Yeah, blew it inside out. And just on the left here is the St. Jamestown neighborhood. Oh, there we go. This isn't exactly a shining endorsement for this kind of umbrella. You know what? The rain seems to be letting up. It might be time to take the umbrella down. Or just using it to protect the camera. This is Isabella Street. So I'm on the east side of downtown. and I'm making my way towards the Eaton Centre because I ordered an item from a store for pickup. It was a Christmas gift. Someone fighting with their umbrella a bit. So I think what I'll do is I'll turn right at Wellesley Street coming up and I'll head over to Jarvis and I'll kind of zigzag my way down, and maybe Carlton would be the next major east-west street, so I'll take Carlton over to Church and maybe down to Gerard or so. According to the forecast, we're supposed to get some snow flurries later tonight, and the temperature is supposed to drop below zero. So this is Wellesley Street. It's like every time I walk along Wellesley on this stretch, I'm on this side of the street. Let's cross over to the south side. Off in that direction there is Cabbage Town. Walking flu shots available now. And this would be Homewood Avenue. So I'll make a left at Jarvis Street coming up. And the rain has definitely slowed to a trickle. There's a look at the Keg Mansion. It's a large chain steak restaurant, but that would be their flagship location. I think it's well worth a visit. Let's go south on Jarvis, down to Carlton at least. As I walk by the old Jarvis Collegiate Institute. Established in 1807 as the Home District Grammar School. I'm not sure what it's operating as now. I don't believe it's an active high school. Here is Maitland Street. So just off in that direction, that'll take you into the heart of the village, the Church Wellesley Village. That's liberating to fold up the umbrella. There's a lot of really old, beautiful homes on the northeast side of downtown along streets like Jarvis and Sherbourne. Back in the day, as in the late 1800s, this used to be a rather affluent part of town. And there is Canada's National Ballet School. Ballet? Ballet across the street. Once who lived in this building. Tall building here on the right with all the artwork on the side is the old Primrose Hotel, which was later purchased by Ryerson University and turned into a student housing center. which has since been rebranded as Toronto Metropolitan University, as a Carlton streetcar rumbles by. So I'm going to turn right here, which is west on Carlton. Maybe we'll take this over to church. Grace Toronto Church, but just behind that is the Allen Gardens. Turning but not signaling. And it turned into the far left lane. There is a French-speaking school across the street. I think this place has been here pretty much since the beginning of time. Really cool old school diner. I think it'll be time for lunch by the time I pick my item up from the Close Your Ears Kids from the Apple store. And there is the Oasis Aqua Lounge. A very interesting establishment, one I've never been to. That's my understanding. There's a few more like it in the GTA. I know children are not welcome there. Should give you an idea as to what kind of place it is. And this is Church Street coming up. If it's the wind, but the rain seems to be picking up. Japanese noodle house. Oh, that's a Ajisan ramen. The only one of those I've ever been to is the one in Chinatown. I guess I'll stick to the east side of church here. So this is south down Church Street. I'd actually pop the umbrella open again. Make sure the camera lens isn't splattered in raindrops. There's someone with an umbrella. Not a real person. That is Granby Street. And that pub has changed names a number of times over the years on the corner there at Granby. Mama Burger, 2 for $7.99. I've not had A&W in quite a while. Used to have a lot of fantastic deals on their website at awcoupon.ca. But there's been less and less of those, so I've just kind of been avoiding it. Alright, so here's Gerrard Street. If I were sticking to the original plan, I would turn right here and head over to Yonge. But I've covered that stretch of Yonge from Gerrard down to Dundas a fair bit lately. Maybe we'll just stick to Church Street for a few more blocks. This area is passing through part of the Toronto Metropolitan University campus. And you'll notice the gray concrete slab sidewalks here. Or I guess cement. I've given way to a nice interlocking brick. And this is Gould Street. Ram in the Rye, that's their local campus pub. At least I think it is.
No reports, nothing. I mean, other than the project stuff, but the project.
I mean, I didn't read all of it, but like, I like.
And coming up is Dundas Street East. They've turned that old Esso gas station into a presentation center. Centricity. Thank you. think they have to thoroughly excavate the site of an old gas station and do soil tests and that sort of thing. My life was empty until I met you, Mr. Piper. So here we are at Dundas Street East. And burrito boys, I bet that's a popular spot amongst the college crowd here. And was that what I thought it was? I saw a sign for a place called Sovereign Selections, and it looked like a cannabis retailer, one of the not so licensed ones, but they skirt the law by claiming that they are on sovereign territory. I've been curious to go check one of those places out and see how strong the goods are and what the pricing is like. Looks like they're setting up for some kind of event over in Dundas Square. I wonder when that'll be lit up. It'll be worth a visit at night. This area gets a lot of flack, but whenever it's wet outside, I always really like the glow of the lights on the ground around here. And there it is, a rather modestly sized Christmas tree. I'm just going to make my way south a bit to an entrance of Eaton Centre, not this one. This corner is lacking its usual busker and preacher activity.
We can never be a good enough person.
As I say that, I still want to know how many people have converted and changed their lives because they walked past a guy standing on the street just preaching away like that guy. I bet that number is pretty close to zero. And here we are at our destination. So I'm going to put the umbrella away and head over to the store, pick up the item that I prepaid for and reserved, and then go get some lunch. So I hope you enjoyed this walk from Sherbourne and Bloor. Making my way south down the east side of downtown over to here at the Eaton Centre. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below if you wish to support what I do. There's links to Patreon and YouTube channel membership in the description. And I have an Instagram account at Johnny Strides. And there is a super thanks button appearing below these videos. Anywho, thank you for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Yoink!